Arkansans could be voting to raise the minimum wage for workers later this year. That comes a day after Senator Mark Pryor announced he would support raising wages. But some politicians say it could hurt the state's businesses. 4029's Emily Maha spoke with several tonight to find out what it means for them. She's live in Fayetteville. Emily.
Ben, Dixon Street is lined with locally owned stores and restaurants, each one of them paying the state minimum wage, $6.25 an hour. Mallory Bryan is a waitress at Grubbs Bar and Grill. She's one of the many Arkansans who could see a bigger check next year.
Every penny helps.
Senator Mark Pryor says he supports raising the minimum wage by $1.25 starting next year.
Knowing that my paycheck might be a little bit bigger, it's huge news.
But not everyone feels the same.
Leave it alone. That's the best way to enable our folks.
Representative Charlie Collins says raising the minimum wage will hurt the local economy.
Forcing employers not to be able to hire people who want to work at a wage that the employer can pay is just wrong for our government to do, in my view.
But Senator Pryor says this is a good move for businesses.
$8.50 an hour over 3 years is something they think that they can manage and handle. So I don't sense a lot of opposition in the business community at all.
And the group interested in raising the minimum wage will have until the first week in July to collect more than 60,000 signatures before this issue can be put on the ballot in November. Reporting live tonight in Fayetteville, Emily Maha, 4029 News.
And if this issue makes it onto the polls, voters would also be approving a yearly 50-cent increase to the minimum wage through 2017. Pryor's opponent in the U.S. Senate race, Tom Cotton, hasn't said whether he's for or against the increase, but he says he is looking into it.